Hey everybody, welcome back to a brand new video here on the channel. In today's video, I'm going to be teaching you the most efficient ways to rob all stores in Jailbreak. So let's get straight into this video. So first store we're starting off with is the jewelry store. If you don't know already, you can come in from the top here when it's open, which it just did. But how the jewelry store normally starts off is once it opens up, there's a little laser that goes by and you can hit seed and then you can go under that. And then if that is already closed, you can come up to the top here and come through the doors here. And then you have to go through this whole entire maze. So first thing you want to do is get through the obbies and get down and start punching the boxes down here. Currently right now, I am playing the hardest jewelry store robbery right now. And what I would recommend for this floor is taking your time and going, jumping on these jewels. If this is definitely one of the hardest levels in all the jewelry store, but what you want to do is just jump on these jewels and that'll save you from the lasers. You want to wait for this one to come around and then you can just jump over here. And then our final floor before we make it down to the boxes is what you want to do is just watch out for these lasers and make sure you don't hit them. Wait for them to pass by. Wait for this one to pass by. And you can just literally just jetpack over that last one there if you want to. There are multiple jewelry store levels. This right now, the one that I'm doing is the hardest. The easiest one is when you go up on the first floor, there's a whole bunch of jewels. And that one you can just get some free money there. So what you want to do is just start punching these boxes and that will give you some money. The ones over here that seem almost impossible to get, you can just if you punch right here, you can get these easily. So just jump up top here and stand right like this and start punching, and then you'll get those easily. And then normally you have to buy a game pass to upgrade your money, your bag, to $5,000. You will normally start off with $2,000. Once you fill your bag, you can go through back through the obby. There also is a second floor down at the basement here full of jewels. They recently just added that. So now that we have our money, we're gonna go straight back through that obby. You normally wouldn't have to do that if you would have came through the glass there, but since the jewelry store was already closed, oh my gosh, is that a cop? Oh, that's not a cop. Okay, but then we just have to go back through this obby. If you're having troubles with the obbies, just letting you know the jewelry store is one of the hardest obbies in the game. When you're first starting out, I'd recommend getting some free money from the donut shop and the gas station. I will be showing you those robberies soon. Those are very easy robberies. Oh, I almost died there. But, for instance, when you get low, you can eat a donut. Those help out a lot. But then we just have to jump through these jewels again. And so once we make it through this, the next robbery coming up will be the museum. Definitely one of my favorite robberies. I enjoy it very much. It gives you 6,000 cash when you have big bags, like $7,000 if you have VIP. So what we want to do is just come straight back through this obby, and I will be showing you where you can turn your money. It also says down under the money, make your way to the criminal base. So I have the vault bike here, and I'm going to take this over towards the crime base. Very easy drive. You just come over here and drive in here, and you get your 5,000 cash, or 2,000, depends on if you have the game pass. Next one I will be showing you is the museum. So first thing you want to do when you're coming up here is you drive around the mountain, and once you get up here, if you have the jetpack, you can just jetpack up here. If not, there's ladders to the left over here, and there's one over to the right. But normally this will take a little while. As you can see, I have 39 seconds until the museum opens. But what you want to do is you have to have two people here, and one person has to place the dynamite, and then the other person has to place the dynamite over here. This is not a solo robbery. You have to do this with one other person. You need two people to survive the obby as well. That is very crucial to get the money for this. This is a very good robbery if you're wanting to get money. I will be showing you guys is the gas station and the donut shop. Very easy robberies. Very easy to do. Easy way to get your couple thousand so you can start off in this game. Let's get straight into this museum robbery. So now, once you have two people, one of them just has to place the dynamite, and then you fall through this hole. There are multiple places to rob. The most efficient way for me, back when the jetpack wasn't packed down, is you take out a gun, pop that right there, and then you can grab these. The donut gives you 4, cone gives you 1, and the gold gives you 3. That is my most efficient way to get your bag filled quickly. Then you're just gonna come through this obby, and if you don't know already, both of these puzzles have to be solved. I'm gonna be doing the laser one here, where you just have to line up all these lasers. So now we unlock the door and we are free to go. But once to get our money, we have to turn in this money. So we're gonna wanna go to the volcano base. So I'm gonna take my Volt Bike over here and I'll see you at the volcano base. So most efficient way is take this ramp and then you can just go up in here, zigzag through and turn in your money here. That is my most efficient way to rob the museum. I will be showing you ways to rob, the most efficient way to rob the gas station and donut shop. There isn't really an efficient way, I guess it's really easy, but I'll just show you the robbery anyway. So now that I am at the gas station here, I am going to walk in and just hold E. It's very, very simple. It's the same as the donut shop and it's quite simple. If there's a little bar that pops up, but nope, we got our cash. So that will give you 1,500. Normally it will give you 750 if you don't have the Big Bags Game Pass. And then the donut shop is completely the same. If there is a message that pops up saying that they don't have enough money right now, it's that means that someone has recently robbed this store and it takes like 5 or 10 minutes for the money to reset. So now that we're at the donut shop, we're just gonna do the same thing. Very, very simple, get some easy quick cash. And once our E-circle is finished, we should either get an error message or some cash. Wow, both of those robberies worked out just fine. Next robbery I'm going to be showing you is the most efficient way to rob the power plant. To know if the power plant is open, is all these stacks should be steaming like this. That means that the power plant is open. If they aren't steaming, that means that it is closed. So, you know the quick drill, you come up here, you know, you do the puzzle, the door opens. Recently, they've nerfed the jetpack in here, so you have to do this obby, so you just bam, bam, bam. No crouching or anything, but easiest way is when you're right up there, you can just jump up here, come over here. And some of these puzzles can be quite hard. You can just, if they're too hard, you can reset the puzzle. But what you want to do is finish this puzzle here. I'll get back to you when I finish the puzzle. And bam. Now that we've finished our puzzle, we're just gonna come through here. So you're just gonna grab your vehicle, grab it quickly, and the fastest way I'd say is the Volt Bike to get back to the base, or the military helicopter. Those both cost 1 million, but to get the max amount of cash, I think it's 5,600. We are definitely not gonna get that, but what you wanna do is you just wanna race over to the volcano base, do that same trick I showed you with the museum robbery cash. I'm just gonna come over here. Use the ramp. Come through here. Bing, bang, boom, and room. So I got 4,650. You can get more cash, just depends on how fast you are. I couldn't find my vehicle for a bit, so I probably could have gotten more cash. And that is my most efficient way to rob the power plant. One other tip about the power plant, if you do have the garage spawn, what I would do is wait until you almost finish your thing and then spawn the Volt Bike, and then that should be a really quick way if you don't know where your Volt Bike is at, and you can just go. So that is my efficient way to rob the power plant. So once the bake's open, what you're wanting to do is you have to have a key. Oh crap, there's a car. Are you kidding me? Are you actually freaking serious right now? Get out of here, turd bag. Okay. Now that you have a key, what you're wanting to do is go through these doors, you know, open up the vault. See what bank we get. But what you want to do is, honestly, there's not that much to explain, but just jump over everything, do the obby as quickly as you possibly can. Recommend staying all the way to the right. And if any cops come in, either just beam them or try not to die. Try not to let them in the vault, because that'll automatically arrest you. But honestly, that's about it. Once you get all your money in here, I'd recommend, if you have a key, going up through that door the same way that you came. So I have my 5,000 cash, and I'm just gonna go back through the obby. And once I'm done with the obby, okay, so we got our 5,000 cash from that. Next, Robert, I'm gonna be showing you is the cargo plane. So what you're gonna wanna do is wait for the cargo plane to land. Come up in through here. Very simple, very easy. You must have a key card to do this robbery. Pick a box here, and now we're just going to wait for the door to close. So now that we have this, it says deliver crate to cargo port. I'm gonna open the door here. We're gonna go out, drop your parachute. What I normally like to do is get the classic over here, and I will be taking it to the port where you can get your money. Then you just take it over here past the criminal base, come over here to this port over here, and right here, this is where you turn in your money. You can hop out, you can drive over it, but all you have to do is just stand over here. Look, I leveled up, got 5,000 from that robbery. You can get, again, 7,500 from that robbery, or you can get a key card and 5,000 from that robbery. That is all for me. There isn't any more robberies. I will catch you guys in the next one, and see ya. Bye.